have to have a good two-way communication system. And the communication system must be designed together with the parents. So you have to take it into consideration what the parents, what platforms the parents are using, and you cannot really impose any platforms on them. If they prefer coming in person, or if you have this feeling that they would be happier coming in person, then you have to set up the channels, the communication channels, by providing a meeting room where the parents can freely come and meet the teachers. But if the parents, for example, prefer Facebook, then the teacher cannot opt out. I have had these funny kind of interactions with teachers telling me that I'm very conscious about my private life, so I'm not on Facebook. And how are you communicating with your class? Well, they know that I'm not on Facebook. But that's not the way. Of course, a teacher have to be very conscious of his or her private life, but the majority of teachers will have two Facebook accounts, one for private life and one for the school life. Another very important structure or more framework that needs to be in place is some kind of code of conduct. So one thing is to set up communication channels and communication frameworks, but you also have to agree on how you are agreeing on that, how you are using them. So you have to make an agreement on what time is the right time to call, how quickly you will have to send a response, regardless if you're a teacher or a parent. So you do have to have this kind of mutually agreed code of conduct. I absolutely believe that whatever framework there is, it must be based on the principle of nothing about them without them. So whatever structure is there, it has to include the children. And it's difficult, especially difficult when it comes to primary school or even kindergarten. But you have to find the methodology to really have the voice of children. And it will not be children sitting through long, boring meetings. But you will have to use other types of methodology that is there. You just have to learn you have to learn how to use it, and you actually have to implement it. Another structure that needs to be in place for a good parents, teachers, I would use the plural, parents, teachers relationship is some kind of decision-making process where you have to have meaningful participation from all the parties, from the children, from the parents, from the teachers. In different countries, there are different methodologies for the participation of the school head. In some countries, the school head is a member of these decision-making bodies, but there are countries where the school head only has a veto right. So if all the stakeholders agree on something that doesn't make sense, then the school head can come in and say, no, sorry, it doesn't make sense, I cannot implement it, or just find another school head. So the structures, in my opinion, are physical and mostly communication structures. And unfortunately, according to my experience, very often both are missing from the school. So that you don't have the physical contact possibilities. There is no schedule for teachers when they have to be there for the parents. It doesn't take into consideration that the parents have probably different working hours from the teachers. And if you really want to have a parent-teacher relationship, you cannot go home at 2 o'clock and say that if you want to meet me, you have to come between 9 and 2. The structures that are physical and also virtual also need to be a kind of compromise where both sides will need to sacrifice some. And unfortunately, from a teacher's perspective, it is what is considered free time for them. It's after school hours or even weekend.